What time is it?
It's pirate time!
Hey everybody, what time is it?
There's no time like pirate time.
Nobody is ahead, nobody's behind.
Everything's fine on pirate time.
And you'll be living on island time. Caribbean breezes blow through my mind. We're sand meets sea, that's where you'll
I'm living on island time. I may be late, but you know I'm trying to make the best of an uphill climb. There's just so much I can do to make it through. I'm living on island time. Being laid back is my only crime. Trying to find a little peace of mind. Living on island time.
All right, from the campus of Baldwin Wallace University on the North Coast, it is Trap Rock Music on the Radio. It is the Island Time Radio Show. How's everybody doing tonight? DK, Dennis King on duty. Cheryl's with us, fresh from New York City.
Christmas in the city.
You saw it. Yeah, we'll have to talk about this.
Yeah.
How fun is that?
Nice decorations. It was a lot of fun.
I'll bet. Welcome back from, she just got in. This has become the first stop after arriving home from the flights lately. So there we go. We got a fun show. We got some great interviews from Music Meeting of the Minds in Gulf Shores. And I think the second one tonight was actually done at Cindy Muir's house concert. But we'll talk about that later on. Let's get to things, though. It's Thanksgiving week, as we know. And here is Steve Stafford with a Thanksgiving song right here on Island Time.
One cold Thanksgiving day, it was the year my grandpa came to stay. He had a long, rough life, full of troubles and strife. So I asked him why he was thankful on that day. And he looked at me and he said, I got food on the table, got a shirt on my back, I got friends and family, got a dog and a cat. Every day you're living is a gift to unwrap. So every Thanksgiving I'm thankful for that. As I grew up and tried to get ahead, struggled every day to earn my bread. So many people have so much more, so what am I thankful for? And I recall the words my grandpa said. I got food on the table, got a shirt on my back, got friends and family, got a dog and a cat. Every day you're living is a gift to unwrap. So every Thanksgiving I'm thankful for that. Another Thanksgiving day has arrived, and it means much more than football games and pies. 'Cause when I sit down to say grace, a smile comes across my face when I recall the words of a man so wise. I got food on the table, got a shirt on my back, got friends and family, got a dog and a cat.
Every day you're living is a gift to unwrap. So every Thanksgiving, I'm thankful for that. Got food on the table, got a shirt on my back. Got friends and family, got a dog and a cat. Every day you're living is a gift to unwrap. So every Thanksgiving, be thankful for that.
Traveling in our tribe. Well, we know that that summer ain't just a season, it's one hell of a state of mind. And we only need a few little things to have us a damn good time. All right. Got a little suntan on my skin, got a little Captain in my flask, got a little water in my windshield, got a little Molly on full blast, got a little sunshine in my eyes, got a little tripe rock in my room, got a little Holly riding shotgun, got a little sand in my soul. Something you can't find, you know it's right before your eyes. Oh yeah. Got a little suntan on my skin, got a little Captain in my flask, got a little water in my windshield, got Bob Marley on full blast, got a little sunshine in my eyes, got a little tribe rock.
Joe Downing, right here on Island Time tonight with Sand in My Soul. We had Eric Erdman with a brand new recording, a song called A Little Too Late, and Steve Stafford out of, he's out west, where is he? In California, that's right. He is with Uncle Monkey, the Uncle Monkey Band, Steve Stafford, and the Thanksgiving song. Starting things off tonight on the Island Time Radio Show, DK Dennis King on duty. Cheryl is with us again. Welcome back, Cheryl.
Thanks. It's great to be back.
How was New York City?
It was fun. A lot of walking.
Yeah.
We saw some shows.
Yeah.
Ate a lot.
Yeah, well, there you go.
Good food.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
I saw some video and pictures and reunions.
Yeah, stuff well, like that. It, can't even call it a family reunion. It was a family union.
Oh, okay.
Because Michael came up from Philadelphia to visit Sarah and I, and Sarah and Michael had never met, even though...
Oh, really?
They're uncle and niece.
Really? Well, yeah. The way they responded, I thought they'd known each other forever. Interesting. Okay.
Only on texting.
Oh, wow. Very interesting. All right. We've got an interview this hour with Joe Downing, Florida trap rocker, and tell us how this came together, because it's you, and I think Nikki might be on this, yeah.
Yeah. Well, when we were heading down to Meeting of the Minds, I messaged Joe and asked if he would be willing to do an interview for the show, and he jumped at the chance. He was excited to do it.
Very cool.
Yeah. Well, and this... It was only about 6 weeks after the serious accident he had. And
he had some kind of motorcycle or car
accident.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, and he had his wrist, he has plates and screws in his wrist, I believe. So I told him I was going to check out his wrist when we got there. For those of you who don't know, I'm a retired physical therapist.
Yes.
Yeah.
In fact, I have to talk to you about some things later on tonight.
We won't retired.
We won't go over the on the air.
But he was able to play the guitar, which was great.
Excellent.
Yeah, and he'll talk a little more about that.
Okay, so he's getting back into the groove.
Yeah.
Beautiful. All right, well, Cheryl, we'll talk to Joe Downing right after this very quick break on Thanksgiving week here on the Island Time Radio Show tonight. We'll be back right after this quick break. All right, let's go down to Gulf Shores, Alabama, Cheryl, and hear your Joe Downing interview.
All right.
Right now. Here we go.
Hi, this is Cheryl and Nikki. We're the roving reporters at Meeting of the Minds in Gulf Shores, Alabama. We have a guest tonight, Joe Downing. Welcome, Joe.
Hey, great to be here.
We heard Joe the other night at DMAX with his full band. You sounded great.
Thank you so much. It was a fantastic time.
It was great to see you playing the guitar so soon after your accident. So tell us how things are going for you.
Well, things are going better than expected, and I'm, you know, really, really pleased with being able to play guitar. And just a couple months after I broke my left wrist and had to have some surgery on it.
Do we need to start again? People.
So it's great to be able to play guitar again. For a while there, I wasn't able to do that, and I did get to focus on vocals and some song ideas and things, so those are coming along great. But it's been great to be back with the Joe Downing Band, playing at D-Max in Orange Beach. And we are set to perform at the Yard House Concert in Tampa, Florida, in November. And again, in Tampa at Music on the Bay. So, good things on the way. And just want to thank everybody out there who... this community that came to our aid during this time, and the calls and the prayers and the support that everybody gave was unbelievable, and really made a difference in my recovery. So you know, really happy to be back and making music again.
That's awesome. It's a small community, very connected, and I love the connection between the artists and the audience, and that's what makes it special.
Absolutely. You know, yeah. This Trap Rock community and the Parrot Head clubs everywhere is, you know, it's a testament to the strength of the community and the heart of the community, and I'm just very blessed and feel very thankful to be a part of it and be here with everybody getting to do this. You know, it's fantastic.
So your last album was what, 2 years ago?
About a year and a half ago.
Are you working on songs for a new album?
Always working on new songs, and hoping to record a third album in 2024. So, you know, it's a big task. Right now I'm just kind of focused on the tunes that I'm going to put on there.
Great. What's your inspiration as you write?
Inspiration comes from all over the place. Sometimes I'm just driving down the road and, something hits you, you know, you hear a phrase or something and you think, oh, that'd be a good song. Or you're having a good conversation with friends and, somebody says something, you say, hey, we should put that in a song, you know? So,
you never know where it'll
you
come
never
from.
Know really, but you know, I think it's everywhere. It's what people say and how they communicate that if you can grab onto those special moments and those special conversations and put them in a song, it can really it can make a great tune, you know.
Nikki, you want to ask your question?
Yeah, so you know, that kind of actually is a great segue into what I wanted to ask you, Joe, and that is, is there a particular song or a particular melody or something that you feel really is very impactful for you that you love performing more than any other, or at a specific time? You know, something that's really meaningful for you.
I'd have to say that I guess at different times there's different songs that do different things, you know, and sometimes I'm looking to rock it up and funk it a little bit, and I play one of my songs like Salt Life.
Love that song.
Get everybody up and dancing, you know. Thank you. And you know, other times, one of my favorite songs is from my 2020 release, Songs from the Gulf, which is A Pirate's Prayer.
Oh, that's awesome.
Which, you know, I think all the pirates out there and everybody doing all their stuff out there, every once in a while you need to just stop, and we all need a prayer every once in a while, you know. So it depends.
Amen.
Depends on the moment, you know. Depends on the moment.
That's awesome. No, I think that's true, because there's always times where something is more impactful for you on any given day, depending on what kind of path you're walking on at that moment in time.
Absolutely. It's very true, which is why there's so many good songs in trap rock, you know, for different times and different occasions.
Absolutely. There's always something that strikes you. And, you know, there's times where I'll hear something and I'll actually have to pull my car over to the side of the road because that song is hitting me so strong at that moment in time. And there's a couple of songs that definitely do that. So I appreciate that. And yours are among them. So glad to have you with us, Joe.
Thank you so much. Yeah. It's awesome to be here.
Yeah, we're so glad you're here. So glad we got to see you the other night. I hope to see more of you in the future. We'll definitely be at Music on the Bay.
We will.
So
very cool. And
will it be your whole band at Music on the Bay?
It will be the Joe Downing Band Friday night at Music on the Bay. We're really excited about that. And excited about a trip later to the Galveston area for an event with the Upper Texas Coast Parrot Head Club with the Joe Downing Band. And lots of good things on the horizon, so looking forward to it, and always enjoy being on Island Time.
And we're hoping for Cleveland as well.
That's right. A little trip maybe coming up to Cleveland and on up to Pittsburgh, so exciting stuff.
Great.
Well, don't forget about Tennessee sometime in there, too.
Absolutely. Absolutely. How could I forget about Tennessee?
Well, we thank you for taking the time to talk to us tonight. And enjoy the rest of the week.
Thank you so much. It's been great.
Thank you, Joe.
Thank you.
You'll know you only live once. So go ahead, have you some fun. Drinking rum in the sun. Holding hands with the one that you love. She loved all your blues away. I was walking down a Floridian beach. Saw an old man with no shoes on his feet. Wearing a shirt that read, catching little phrase that got stuck in my head. It said, YOLO, you only live once. So go ahead, have you some fun. Drinking rum in the sun, holding hands with the one that you love. Cause she loved all your blues away. So YOLO, you only live once kind of day. About a friend so right that it couldn't be wrong. All I'm gonna tell you is all I'm gonna say. It's time for no work and a whole lot of play. Hey, YOLO, you only live once. So go ahead, have you some fun. Drinking rum in the sun. Holding hands with the one that you love. Cause she loved all your blues away. It's a YOLO, you only live once kind of day. You only live once kind of day.
everyone's checking you out, and you don't see what the big deal's about. You be smoking, smoking on the beach. You be smoking, smoking on the beach. From your long hair down to your bare feet, believe me, girl, I can take the heat. You be smoking, smoking on the beach. Walking on the shore, waiting, coming off the sea. You set the coast on fire, hanging out with me. And right about now, I feel like a man. Cause baby, I'm the one holding your hand. And you be smoking, smoking on the beach. You be smoking, smoking on the beach.
Right, that is Joe Downing from his most recent album. You said Joe said it was like a year and a half ago. I was going to say it's like brand new. It's a year and a half old for crying out loud. The Bright Side is the name of the album, and we just heard Smoking on the Beach. And YOLO was in there, a classic from 2021, around there. And Sand in My Soul, which is also on The Bright Side. Very nice job, you guys, Nikki and
Thank you. Thank you. Except for the noise in the background.
Yes, we have to call her out. Erica Sunshine Lee was wreaking havoc in the background. It was apparently
she was exiting the Trop Rock Music Awards, and I don't
there
know
might
what
have
was
some,
going on. But
there might have been some celebratory cocktails at the Trop Rock Awards.
I'm sure there were.
In Gulf Shores. So there you go. We'll get Eric on, actually on the mic one of these times.
Intentionally.
There we go. Back to the music. This is, we still got some Jimmy Buffett cuts from this Equal Strain on All Parts album. And I finally got my copy yesterday after all this time.
Yay!
And we have not yet played all the cuts here on the show. This one is called Portugal or PEI. And I listened to the whole thing and I love it. It's a great... sadly, final album. And let's check it out right here on Island Time Tonight. Jimmy Buffett.
Portugal. I was born with that nomad gene. There's very little of this planet that I have not seen. Everybody's on a soapbox, influencers and phones. Tick-tock, Tommy Rock, round the clock, but I'm still thinking Rolling Stones. So where am I gonna go when the volcanoes blow? Everybody's asking all the time, contemplating my back bay or a beach bar near Sagre. I'm sure I'll find a way. Till then I'll be in the conga line.
Love in Portugal or PEI, laying low, staying high. I got my good friends close and trouble far away. Music on a beach cross singing sands. No big deal, no master plan. We'll be alright come Monday.
Across the ocean on friendly archipelagos, where women sing to Gaia and the marijuana grows.
I'm thinking garden of the gulf, where the Portuguese fished long ago. Speak a little Mi'kmaq when I can, and in Cavendish do the do-do-do.
Where am I gonna go when the volcanoes blow? Everybody's asking all the time, contemplating Malbec Bay or a beach bar near Sagre. I'm sure I'll find a way. Till then I'll be in the conga line.
A pub in Portugal on PEI, laying low, staying high. I got my good friends close and trouble far away. Music on a beach cross singing sands. No big deal, no master plan. We'll be alright come Monday.
Everybody's playing TikTok, Tommy Rock, and I still love the Rolling Stones. Life is always better when you add a little island. A lot of oysters, love and wine. Maybe a pub on PEI with somebody singing in Portuguese on the sandbar. Feel the ocean breeze right now. That sounds real good to me. I really like those possibilities. Till then I'll be in the conga line.
Morning buzz is the best because there's something brewing for me and you. To the kitchen I go, back before you know, with a couple of cups for that thing we do. I can't wait for what comes next when I crawl back in bed. Coffee and kisses, waking up like this is a dream coming true.
The taste of me.
Coffee and kisses.
take a sip, lick our lips, spend all morning in bed. Coffee and kisses, waking up like this is
a dream coming true.
The taste of me and you, delicious.
Carry me back home.
All right, folks, that is a very special song. That is a brand new one from the Doobie Brothers. Mick Fleetwood is on drums, and who else is on that? Jake Shumabukuru from Jimmy Buffett fame, as you know. Did you go see him in concert?
Yeah, we saw him down recently at the Music Box.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All the money from that single, if you download it, will go to the victims of the fires in Maui. You know, we've had so much tragedy around the world since the summer. Everybody's forgot about Hawaii and Maui and the whole thing. You know, it's like, oh, yeah. You know, it's several months ago. Patrick Simmons from the Doobie Brothers has lived in Lahaina for 30 years. Mick Fleetwood, you were telling me, has a restaurant down there.
Yes.
So they all
He lives in Lahaina.
Yeah. So they all teamed up and made this new record. It's called Lahaina. So download that if you get a chance. Great cause. Christopher Dale, our buddy Christopher, with a new partner, Rhea McCarris, and Coffee and Kisses. Beautiful love song right there. Valentine's type
stuff. That is really a pretty song.
Yeah. And Portugal, or PEI, from Jimmy Buffett and the Equal Strain on All Parts album. And DK on Duty. Next hour, we've got another interview. It's going to be Cindy Muir with John McDonald. And we also got another Whiskey Wanderings coming your way. How about that?
Ooh-hoo.
Right now. Don't get too excited, Cheryl. Let's do a Friends on the Bay, some Bob Gatewood. What do you think on Island Time?
Sounds great.
There we go.
Just like yesterday, but I knew right then that I found a place where my troubles could all fade away. And since then I've been back so many times, and each time it's always the same. The people and places, smiles and the faces, they all remember my name. Hello, friends of the Bay. Thank you for coming today. Hello, water so blue, I'll always remember you. Toast to tomorrow. I can't count all the nights that we talk until dawn. I can't count the friends I've made. So many memories of the times I've had, and I'll carry them all to my grave. Hello.
Hey, this is Gary from Landsharks, wishing you a happy Thanksgiving. And right now, I'm going to do a little trop rock turkey in the straw in hopefully under 25 seconds. Trop Rock Thanksgiving.
Strawberry daiquiri, sand on my bare feet, throwing a frisbee on the beach. It feels good. Mama's old wooden swing, sipping on the real thing. Catching one on the riverbank, it feels good. It feels good when you got somebody to hold. Free bird flying high, rock and roll. Sweet salvation in your soul. That's solid gold. It feels good. Fireworks in the night, like freedom in July, 2 and a 4x4 drive, it feels good. Sleeping in on Saturday, sweet kisses all on my face, loving all this love we make, it feels. Gets old, sweet salvation in your soul. That's solid gold. It feels good. Got this feel-good melody, daydreaming, stuck on repeat. It feels good. It feels G-double-O-D good to me. Smile on my face in a summer breeze, catching them Kodak memories. 1, 2, 3. It feels good when you got somebody to hold. Me and Willie back on the road. Sweet salvation in your soul. It feels good. To that rugged cross, he already paid the cost and found my soul when it was lost, and it feels good.
That is Becky Denton right there, title track from her brand new EP, It Feels Good. We also had Friends of the Bay from Bob Gatewood in there, and Lahaina from the Doobie Brothers. How cool is that?
I've traveled all around the world, and there are places that still stand out to me, but none can really quite compare to my island in the sea. My personal utopia, a place to run to, where I can hide away, where I can truly reign supreme, somewhere fresh and clean, where a man can dream. I'm king,
king,
king of somewhere hot. I'm king,
king,
like every man should be. I'm king,
king,
king of somewhere hot, with the music in my soul, makes me start to lose control, and I'll melt right on the spot. I'm the king of somewhere. Just rent yourself a time and dance the night away, just like the locals do. A million miles from Robin Leach, life is just a beach, so far out of reach. I'm king,
king,
king of somewhere hot. I'm king,
king,
like every man should be. I'm king,
king,
king of somewhere hot, with the music in my soul, makes me start to lose control, and I'll melt right on the spot. I'm the king of somewhere.
Well, I am an American Caribbean, just living on the sword island and keeping 10 toes in the sand. Come on. Came down from Nashville, Tennessee. I got tired of city walls and streets, and I found out quick reality is bitter by the shore and salty sea. And that's why I am an American. Living on the sword island and keeping 10 toes in the sand. I sit and listen to a reggae band. I don't really have no plan. Maybe tipping back a taco game and keeping 10 toes in the sand. 'Cause I am an American Caribbean. Pull that anchor up and float away. Well, come on down, 'cause son, I know a place where the sun will paint a smile across your face. And that's why I am an American Caribbean, just living on the sword island, keeping 10 toes in the sand. I sit and listen to a reggae band. I don't really have no plan. Maybe tipping back a taco cane and keeping 10 toes in the sand. 'Cause I am an American Caribbean right now. Won't you come and taste some rum, son? You won't be going back. And that's why I am an American Caribbean, just living on this old island and keeping 10 toes in the sand.
Jesse Rice, right here with America Caribbean, something like that. I think that's the title. From Jesse Rice 3, Pirate Sessions, or 4, I'm sorry. And we thought we'd lead Whiskey Wanderings with a Jesse Rice song tonight.
I think that sounds like a great idea.
I think Nikki approves as well. And we had, excuse me, Jimmy Buffett going back to the 80s, King of Somewhere Hot. PK on duty, and we're going to take a very quick break. We're going to come back, talk some whiskey for Thanksgiving. A liquid Thanksgiving right here on Island Time. It is time for Whiskey Wanderings. It is the Thanksgiving edition.
Hey everybody, it's time for Whiskey Wanderings with Nikki, right here on Island Time Radio. Yes, sir.
I love whiskey. I love whiskey. Don't you know I love whiskey? Yeah. Mm-mm. Whiskey. Oh, yeah.
Quite a long opening, I tell you what. And here she is. It's just like Johnny Carson. Nikki!
Hey!
What's going on?
Hey, GK. Hey, Cheryl. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Doing all right. Doing all right. I love the pictures from New York.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, it was a good time, especially introducing Sarah and Michael.
That looks really cool. I love that. That is awesome. And what a great week to do it during Thanksgiving. Like, how special is that?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah.
And we had beautiful weather there, too.
It's good because the weather isn't going to be good where you are and where I am this week. So it was nice to enjoy it while it lasted.
Yeah. I was sweating walking around Central Park.
Really?
Like Gulf Shores.
Yeah.
So you guys had some pretty good weather down in Alabama, huh?
We did. It was warm. It was nice. It never rained. It was just perfect. It was awesome. I enjoyed it. I thought Gulf Shores was fantastic.
Really? Okay. Highly recommended.
Absolutely. 5 stars. Would recommend.
Really?
100%. Yep.
Okay. Have you ever been to Key West?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
I love Key West. Key West gets 6 stars.
Okay.
On a scale of 5.
That's right.
I was going to ask you to compare it, but we won't go into that.
It's just a different vibe.
It's a whole different vibe. Ball game, right?
Yeah.
You got to meet Mr. Whiskey Wanderings, Dave Sines, I heard. How fun is that?
I did. That was so fun. That was great. I had the chance to talk with him before the TRMA Awards and introduced myself. And I said, hey, you did my lead-in music. And he's like, oh, that's cool. So we had a great little conversation about that and met him and his wife, Beth, and Beth Travers, of course. And
that's right,
it was a fun opportunity. Thanks for letting us represent Island Time. I was kind of bummed we didn't win, but it was a great opportunity to get to go to the awards and see how all that worked. That's pretty cool.
Well, now that you're part of the show, Nikki, you'll get used to losing every year in the awards. It's an annual tradition around here.
DK promised I could do the acceptance speech on the air, and he hasn't had me do it yet.
I thought of that yesterday or last week. Can you? I don't have to do it right now, but sometime we'll have to pretend like we want.
I can do it anytime you want.
All right, how about next week on the show? We'll pretend that I won, and Cheryl will do our acceptance.
Yeah, Nikki and I will accept the award.
Okay, sounds good. I was interested to hear what you guys were going to say.
I told you. You didn't give me any ideas. I'm sorry, Nikki.
Oh, Cheryl kept it a secret for me, so I didn't know what was going to happen if we went up there.
Well, Dennis, I told you that if you didn't give me any ideas, you should be very afraid of what
right.
we would write.
I know. That's what I'm saying. Without any proofreading or whatever.
Yes.
All right. So it is Thanksgiving week, and we're going to just drink some whiskey at Thanksgiving. Now, is this going to be part of your dinner, Nikki?
Well, I think so.
Okay.
I mean, all I have to do this year is bake a pie and go across the street to the neighbor's house. So, I see. I'm pretty excited about that. And actually, I think a bunch of us from the East Tennessee Parenthood Club are going to head down south of town. Tall Paul's in town, and he's playing a show on Thanksgiving night. So, I think that might be a cool opportunity to, you know, get out of the house and go enjoy some music that night as well.
Excellent. I'll have to ask my buddy Rich if he's going to that. Yeah.
I would be inclined to think perhaps. That would be great.
All right.
So we're talking about whiskey and Thanksgiving food, because now, of course, you can do the obvious and just, you know, drink whiskey all day while you watch, you know, football and
while you're cooking.
While you're cooking. But there's actually kind of some really kind of fun traditions that I would encourage people to maybe give a try to. One of those, and I didn't even know about this until I moved to the South, people will brine their turkeys in bourbon.
Really?
A day before, and then they cook the turkey. So they'll brine it in a, like, picture like a Home Depot bucket, right? Lined with a plastic bag, and they put the turkey in there, and with some seasonings and some different flavorings and whatnot. But they'll brine the turkey in bourbon. And so if that's something that you want to do, there's a lot of different recipes out there for all the seasonings and things that you can put together in it. But I would caution people about which whiskey that they select is going to have a big impact on the flavor that it would impart into the turkey. And so if you guys remember from some of the different things we've talked about, that the mash bill can have a big impact on the flavor, right?
Right.
So if you have a wheated bourbon or a wheated whiskey, it's going to be a little bit sweeter. And if you've got one that's a little bit heavier on the rye side, you're going to get more of those cinnamon, nutmeg, spicy types of flavors. So if you're going to brine your turkey, I would probably stay away from the wheated bourbons, because otherwise it's going to pick up too much sweetness. And I would go for something in more of the rye family, so that you would get a little bit more of that savory and spicy kind of feeling with that. So you brine the turkey, and then you put it in the oven, and or however you choose to cook it. You know, some people here will do it on the grill, or there's a lot of different ways that you could make can cook up your bird. But I would definitely go more towards the rye side if I was going to be doing a brine on the turkey. So now we get into kind of some of the side dishes. Now, what's your favorite side dish, DK? For Thanksgiving.
Oh, for Thanksgiving, mashed potatoes, green beans, maybe some stuffing.
All right.
Yeah.
So all the stuff that is made with butter and cream and all of that stuff. And what is that? That's all stuff that's made with fat, right? So butter is fat, milk is fat, cream is fat. So that is going to actually have an impact on your palate. So if you're drinking whiskey as your beverage of choice during your meal, you're going to probably want to look for a whiskey that's going to have a little bit richer flavor profile. I would actually go for something that's maybe double oaked or has a double finish, like something that's finished in port. Because otherwise, with all of the fat that's in your mashed potatoes and your stuffing and all of that, it's actually going to impact what you're able to pick up, because it's going to close down some of your taste buds.
Wow.
So you want to actually go for something that's a little more full-bodied to drink during your meal, if you're going to have whiskey as your beverage during the meal.
My problem that I can see is I like to drink a lot of liquids during my meal to get the food down, because sometimes I struggle getting everything down. If I was drinking whiskey, I'd be plastered by the end of that.
You very well could be. You may want to temper that with, like, you know,
water.
A glass of water,
yeah.
And then a whiskey and a glass of water and a whiskey. Along those lines, if you're somebody who likes to drink milk with your meals, that's going to have a big impact on how much of that whiskey that you're picking up or being able to taste with your meal.
Now, why is that?
Now, because, again, that fat content is going to impact. It kind of coats the inside of your mouth, so you don't get that same, you don't get to pick up all of those fine flavors that are kind of at the at the upper and the lower ends of the spectrum, of the taste spectrum.
Okay.
So so kind of important. But then what's the most important part, though, of the Thanksgiving, Cheryl? Cheryl, what's your favorite part of the Thanksgiving?
Well, the pumpkin pie, of course.
Right. So pumpkin pie, pecan pie or pecan or however, you know, it's pronounced a thousand ways.
But the dessert.
Yeah, the dessert part. I make my favorite pie. I make a cranberry walnut pie. I make it with fresh cranberries that I actually get sent back down here from Wisconsin. But when you're, so when you're making your pies also, there's some recipes that you can actually throw a little bit of whiskey into to give it some of that flavor. And in this case, I would go for those that have that sweeter palate. So I would be looking for the wheated bourbons or the whiskeys that have more of the vanilla and the caramel flavors. So generally your younger whiskeys, those that haven't been aged quite as long, they're going to have a little bit more of that sweetness. So those are going to be better if you're going to actually cook with those in the recipe. And also if you're going to have those as a dessert, you know, you're going to have your whiskey as your dessert while you're having dessert. Kind of a fun thing is that if you have something like, you know, sometimes people make apple pie and they'll kind of do that salt on the edge, or they'll add a little bit of salt to it to kind of give it, to kind of make that apple flavor pop. That's a really cool thing to do. Where you want to go with your whiskey on that one, though, is you're going to want to go with something that's more kind of in the middle ranges of a rye, so a lower rye, and that's going to bring out those spices, that cinnamon flavor. But if you go too high on the rye spectrum, it's going to be almost too much cinnamon, and that's going to be a little bit too potent. So those would be kind of the directions that I would say you might want to have some fun with. And try some different things. You could even, you know, make a pie and have a couple of different whiskeys and see how that flavor of the pie kind of changes.
Interesting.
Or how that changes what you're tasting with the whiskeys.
Wow. I did not realize that would change the taste of your food.
It does. That
makes
it's
sense,
really kind of fun how it all can blend together.
So it sounds...
And you can have a... Oh, go ahead, Cheryl.
I was going to say, it sounds like Dennis has to do that experiment on Thanksgiving.
I think so.
Go ahead.
Oh, no, I was just going to say, it's just kind of a fun way to try some different things and experiment a little bit. And, you know, you can pick up as you're maybe going over to someone's house and be like, oh, you know, you can pop on into the liquor store on your way over and, pick up a bottle or two, or even get some, a couple smaller bottles, and just give a try to it and see what you think.
My sister's going to be surprised when I walk in with
bourbon.
I love it. Now, I know you probably don't know, but let's say a typical dinner, since you're an expert in this, Nikki, how much would you consume perhaps in the course of a Thanksgiving meal? Would it be just one glass or...
Well, it depends on if the Packers are playing on Thanksgiving Day and how bad they're losing. it has not been a good season so far for Wisconsin sports. I think what I would generally do is I would kind of do it like you would a wine pairing. So I would probably do depending on how you're eating your meal, you might have a whiskey during your appetizers and have something that's going to be a little bit more of a mild flavor that you're having with your whatever you're choosing for your appetizers, you know, which is a lot of times cheese and crackers and that sort of stuff. But then I would probably choose one to have with the meal, maybe one maybe a nice pour during the meal. And then I would probably have a third one with dessert. But it doesn't have to be a full-ounce pour. You know, you can always try a little bit, sample, see what you like, try some different ones during the course of the meal. But it doesn't have to be something where you would have, you know, 3-4 full ounces, because that might be a little bit much for a lot of folks. And then all of a sudden, you know, there's some stories being told and things coming out about Thanksgivings from the past that, somebody said, oh, we were never going to tell that story again.
The truth comes out. The whiskey has launched the truth out of my mouth.
That does happen sometimes. It also makes sometimes those games that you play after dinner, you know, where you break out the Uno, that can get a little bit competitive.
You mentioned the Packers. Are they playing us this year? Are you playing the Browns? I don't even know.
I'm not sure. I've kind of been ignoring the NFL schedule a little bit.
We did that for 20 years.
Yeah. first few games of the season were a little bit painful, and it's like, oh, okay. this isn't so good. Okay. But, you know, we'll see. Badgers are bowl eligible now after beating Nebraska in overtime on Saturday, so I guess we'll celebrate that.
There you go. There you go. We're having a good year, so I'm drinking some whiskey.
You're celebrating. You
well, yeah. Yeah, especially if the Browns are doing well, then that's uncommon. I'd be all for that.
I just told Cheryl we ignored them for 20 years. Yeah, we were doing other things on Sundays, but we're all in now. So pretty exciting. All right, I'm getting off the topic. But thank you, Nikki, unless you got anything else.
No, that basically covers it.
Do you like, is there a certain brand, perhaps, that would be best for this type of meal, or it could be anything, right?
You know, I think if I were going to go to somebody's house and I was going to take a bottle that was going to be a gift for the host, for example,
right.
That could be enjoyed with the meal, I would probably lean towards Angel's Envy or one of the Woodford products, Woodford Double Oaked. That would probably be the direction I would go. Buffalo Trace would be another one. That's a little bit lower price point than the other two, but is actually a really nice whiskey that can sometimes be a little bit hard to find. Those would be the three that I think I would probably start with, in terms of that they would probably go pretty well with all of those different areas that we talked about, with the exception of I would be a little cautious with the Woodford or the Buffalo Trace as the dessert. I would definitely lean towards Angel's Envy for the dessert one.
Angel's Envy? Okay.
Yes.
Those sound familiar from Puddin' Bay.
It does. Yeah, we did. We tasted that.
We did.
Yes, we did.
Excellent. All right, Nikki. Well, you have a great Thanksgiving, and thanks for checking in. And thank you for doing some interviews with us now on the remotes.
Oh, that was fun. I felt bad about the bronchitis. Hopefully next year I won't have that. My voice will be back to normal.
And you're going to Tampa for Music on the Bay, right?
I am. I'm going to Music on the Bay. I'm looking forward to that.
All right. We're going to probably have to team up for some interviews.
She's a Music on the Bay virgin.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
Yeah, this will be my first time down there, so I'm excited for this adventure.
My favorite trap rock event. I mean, Meeting of the Minds is pretty darn good, too, but I don't get there very often. Music on the Bay I usually make every year, and I love it. So looking forward to that so much.
Me too.
All right, everybody listening, drink responsibly. Don't guzzle a bottle of whiskey at Thanksgiving in front of Mom and Dad.
That's right.
Or your siblings or whatever it might be. But
Your children.
thank you, Nikki, so much.
All right, thanks for having me. I'll talk to you guys soon.
All right, fins up to you.
Happy Thanksgiving. Fins up.
Enjoy the Tall Paul party. All right, we've got another interview here in a minute from Cindy Muir. I believe it was recorded at her house. She had John McDonald to her house for a house concert, which is becoming a common thing in the trap rock world. But let's play a track from John's new album first before we get to that. This is Beach More, Worry Less, and then we'll go down to Port A, Texas, right here on Island Time as we get into Homestretch.
Beach More, Worry Less. The world keeps burning while the tide keeps turning to the rhythm of the ripple effect. Beach More, Worry Less. Take a walk in the sun and keep your flip-flops on and love, sweet love. We'll take care of the rest. I got a little salty secret I'd like to share with you. It started with a quiet whisper in a midnight sea of blue. She seemed to know me from a million years gone by. She started chanting in a voice I somehow recognized. Beach More, Worry Less. The world keeps burning while the tide keeps turning to the rhythm of the ripple effect. Beach More, Worry Less. Take a walk in
the sun and keep your flip flops on. And love, sweet love, will take care of the rest. Now I know that I've become a better beach bum on this earth. Ever since that fateful night, I know exactly what it's worth. I follow every dream I wish, for I could see the rainbows in. So find your heart and make a smile to take it to a friend. Each more, worry less. The world keeps burning while the tide keeps turning to the rhythm of the ripple effect. Each more, worry less. Walk in the sun and keep your flip-flops on. And love, sweet love, will take care of the rest.
It don't take much to make the world a little better. Mother Ocean keeps telling us that we're all family.
Hi, this is Cindy Muir with Island Time Radio Show and Dennis King, and I am actually in not only in my hometown of Port Aransas, Texas, but I'm sitting in my living room of my house, and I'm here with John McDonald, and John, we're so glad that you are here. Thanks for making the time to do this little interview with us.
Well, you know what? This was our first time to Port Aransas, and we're on a little tour of Texas, and I've discovered I really like Port Aransas.
Yeah. Everybody does.
Yeah. Oh, no, what a great beach town, you know? I mean, we're used to the panhandle in Florida, but I think Texas has its own coastal vibe, and it's great.
It does. And everybody, the reason that John's here is because he did a house concert last night at our home. So, and it was a terrific show. It was a lot of fun.
I'll tell you, we did have a lot of fun. There's nothing like house concerts for singer-songwriters. You know, I tell everybody, you know, I like to be an entertainer, love to entertain people. I've never stopped doing bars and clubs throughout the years, but you know, you get to be an artist when you're in front of a group of people and you can accentuate and really talk about your own songs.
Right, right, right. So, you were at Meeting the Minds?
Yes, indeed.
And then left to go west.
That's right. We had my tour manager, Donna, otherwise known as my significant other, and everybody knows she's kind of the brains behind the operation. But yeah, we were anticipating coming up to Gulf Shores during Modem, and we started working on a Texas tour. We did a little mini tour a year and a half ago and loved it, and Jerry Diaz helped us out. But now, oh, we're playing, you know, along with you. Today, we're going back up to San Leon. We're playing for B.J. Hendrickson and his wife, Missy. But we're going to be playing for Austin, Galveston Bay, San Antonio. And so we have like, you know, 8, 9, 10 dates. You know, mm-hmm. It's all great. House concerts, shows for parodied clubs. And
right.
We
right.
love it over here.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and this is a good time of the year to be over here. We did have that little cool front. We were talking about when y'all got
y'all went to
Baton Rouge, and all of a sudden, you know, it was like in the Arctic. Now, I know Dennis is laughing about this because of where he lives.
As I was saying, you know, Dennis and I were kind of geographical neighbors. I was Pittsburgh, and he was Cleveland. We were only 2 hours from each other, but we're Rust Belt people, and that's what. And that, and you know, it's like it's the old theory about U.S. Navy recruiting people in the Midwest who are not near bodies of water. It's, you know, I started playing, you know, tropical music and trap rock because of winter.
right. Something to kind of...
It got me through many a cold, bitter winter.
That's right. Mm. Well, tell us now about, you know, new projects going on. I know you had the new album that came out a few months ago.
Yeah, it came out earlier this year. Uh-huh. And that by all accounts, people are digging it so far. It was a TRMA Album of the Year nominee.
Yes.
And that's called Beach More, Worry Less. And, well, here we are in early November, and I have been promising a Trap Rock Christmas album. I've been releasing some Christmas songs incrementally, but we're going to try and get that together. We're going to get out some Trap Rock Christmas songs. And then I'm excited. The next big project I'm going to tackle is we're going to be doing a concept album based on the Jake Sullivan series, our good friend Chip Bell.
Yes, yes.
And as I like to describe Jake, he's the... tropical James Bond. But so Rick Beresford, my primary collaborator, and Rick has been starting to read and go through the books, and he's really digging it. So it's going to be basically inspired by Chip's series of books, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. and that's the next kind of big project. We're going to hopefully get that ready for next year.
Good. That's intriguing.
Well, it's a little different. You know, it's nice to cross-pollinate, you know, when you get people... you know, writing, you know, tropical adventure novels. And clearly, as everybody knows, Chip's books all are inspired by Jimmy Buffett titles. And mm-hmm. he does great research on all the Caribbean islands and destinations. Mm-hmm. So it's just a way to kind of do something a little different and interesting, mm-hmm. you know. Mm-hmm.
And, you know, John Cunningham has worked with Trap Rock.
That's right. That's right.
Matt Hoggett and Dave McKinney, and I'm leaving out P.K. Sykes.
Yeah.
And, Donald James from here in Texas.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's kind of a really neat wrinkle, you know, if you will. that a lot of the you know, or several of the authors are.
That's right. Yeah. And I also, I know when we put this concept together, I know Eric Stone had done a song and Donnie mm-hmm. Brewer also did a song. And I think because, you know, songwriters, we're always looking for new ideas, and you got to get creative grist, you mm-hmm. know, for the creative mill. So when somebody hands you a scenario, a character, it's a template. And if you can sink your teeth into it and find a way in, you have a little world, if you will, and you can tap into that for ideas, mm-hmm. lyrics,
right.
songs.
Right,
you know?
Right. I forgot Tom Shepherd. I shouldn't forget him, that they did Rum Punch, that song together. But anyway, so where can fans see you next live?
Okay, well...
after you leave Texas.
Well, after we leave Texas, well, I'm based on the East Coast over in Melbourne, so we have a whole series of places where we're kind of in the Space Coast area. We're 45 minutes south of Canaveral, so... Oh, if you're in that... Squid Lips is one of the big intercoastal places. Lou's Blues on the beach... the old Fish House, we play a whole series of venues that are popular mm-hmm. on the Space Coast. And, you know, obviously, you know, March will be coming up. That's a big month for me. St. Paddy's Day. So mm-hmm. we do a big Irish show. Mm-hmm. However, one of the things we're doing is for the first time, we're trying it's Trap Rock in the New Year with John McDonald and the Mega Men. It's going to be the East Coast.
Okay.
And so we're doing a New Year's Eve event. So if people want to venture over and do a little something, we were asked to do it because, hey, listen, the right coast, as in the right coast of Florida, we have Parrothead clubs over there, and they're growing. We've got a long way to catch up with the Gulf Coast. But, you know, hey, listen, there's just, you know, there's so much going on, and there's a lot of people to service. But New Year's Eve, we're calling it, one of our friends creatively called it the Bongo Drop.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Because
yeah.
she only came for the bongos.
That's right. Well, good. Okay. Any other Trap Rock festivals you're going to be at this time?
Well, I'm going to be participating in Music on the Bay.
Okay.
And actually, I'm going to be helping out with Rendezvous. We hooked up with Jeff, and I'm going to be hosting something there.
Good.
So.
Both great venues.
Yeah. You know, it's kind of, in a sense, I'm still kind of a new kid on the block. You know, I've been playing Trap Rock for many years, and it was kind of my own version, my own vision. And but you know, as I've gotten to know people in the last 5 or 6 years in Florida, including you, and but I love the genre, I love the vibe, and you know, so we are just I'm focusing on being creative and trying to put out the best music I can.
You know? Right, right. Well, you certainly did a great show last night.
Thank you, dear.
It was wonderful, and we wish you very good luck with the rest of the Texas tour and safe travels back home after that. And you are anything but stagnant.
Remember the Rolling Stone doesn't gather any moss or something. Yeah. So I want to say hi to my good old buddy DK, the first person. I'm going back to almost 1999. I put out my first CD. I was still in Pittsburgh, and at the time, you know, Dennis, as we all know, he's a historian and aficionado of the Beach Boys, but he is the longest running show in Trop Rock, and he's really quite the historian. But at the time, there weren't too many Trop Rock records out of local and regional bands, mm-hmm. and he played the hell out of that. So I'm always mm-hmm. indebted to Dennis.
Yeah, yeah. Dennis, you are a great guy, Dennis. We all love you. Oh, well, John, thanks so much for the time. Y'all know y'all are going to get on the road and head east from here. And I have to say, y'all, that, you know, Dennis mentions Port Aransas or Port A, but there is our iconic bar in Port Aransas. It's called Shorty's. In fact, their slogan is the island's oldest and friendliest. And John and Donna got to go there yesterday. So that's kind of a rite of passage. If you come to Port Aransas, you have to go to Shorty's. So we made that happen yesterday briefly.
Thank you. Thank God we got a little bit of the Shorty's mystique and Port Aransas.
All right. Well, we're going to sign off. Thanks, John, so much again. And thank you, everybody, for listening. This is Cindy Muir with Island Time Radio and Dennis King, and we are out.
Thank you, Cindy, and thank you, John, for the kind words. How fun was that? And this has been great, Cheryl. This whole month has been like vacation. I just sit back and listen to some great interviews, and I straighten my shoulders out while I'm doing it.
Great. Yeah, watch that posture.
I know. I'm learning.
Isn't it fun working with a physical therapist?
It's awesome. You're putting me in the right direction. All right, it's late night. We got only a few minutes left. We're thinking about after the show.
Social!
Ziggy zaggy, ziggy zaggy.
Hoi, hoi, hoi.
Ziggy zaggy, ziggy zaggy.
Hoi, hoi, hoi.
Ziggy zaggy, ziggy zaggy.
Hoi, hoi, hoi.
I'm Spot, Super.
Mike Mad Dog Adams from Put-in Bay. All right, another summer has passed, but Mad Dog, I'm sure, will be doing some mainland shows this winter, so keep our eyes open for that. We got time for just a couple more. Here's one more from John McDonald. This is Rum and Reggae.
Tonight we're gonna solve the whole world's problems. We'll dissolve them in a tropic state of mind. It's getting time to get back to simplicity. Back to you and me, leave the mainland world behind. The future's far away. Let's live just for today. Rum and reggae are simpatico. Rum and reggae liberate our soul. Rum and reggae will intoxicate. We could dance away all our pain and sorrow. Drums.
stars. All we need tonight to get our compass right. Rum and reggae are simpatico. Rum and reggae liberate our soul. Rum and reggae will intoxicate. We could dance right into our tomorrow. Line reverberates, the message resonates, the Rasta mind incantates, the Diwali communicates, lift me up to levitate, our heartbeat motivates, love and peace illuminates. Rum and reggae are simpatico. Rum and reggae liberate.
Jaime del Sol, here in Puerto Backyardo, where las palmas are dancing to the sound of guitarro. Make your hot afternoon be cool at the Playa del Kitty Pool. Come on everybody, let's go. Cantina Jaime del Sol, we got margaritas, of course, any way that you like them. We got modelos, coronas, con limon, it's all so inviting. And I love that sangria wine, I love to drink it with old friends of mine. Stop in and check out the show, Cantina Jaime del Sol. Sound of the steel drum playing always makes me happy. So I say muchas gracias, mi amigo Don Juan Pappy. On the thin line between a good time and out of control, ay, 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 come dance with me down at Cantina Jaime del Sol. Cantina Jaime del Sol, here in Puerto Backyardo, canta y no llores, si alto lindo. Make your hot afternoon be cool at the Playa del Kitty Pool. Come on everybody, let's go. Cantina Jaime del Sol. Del Kitty Pool. Come on, everybody.
cantina Jaime del Sol. Come on, everybody, let's go. Cantina Jaime del Sol.
Sideways drinking wine. The last thing I remember, we were roaring till something hit my head and knocked me from my conscious mind. Just a victim of life's circumstances. I've been raised around barrooms and Friday night dances and singing them old country songs. I got this nasty habit of ending up someplace I don't belong.
Michael Ernst, if you're listening, that's the Jim Morris track of the week, Victim of Life's Circumstances, and Cantina, yeah, del Sol.
Son. Cantina Jaime del Sol.
Thank you, Cheryl. Thank God you're here. Jaime?
Jaime.
Del Sol. From Sonny Jim White and his brand new album, Waiting for the Tide. And we had rum and reggae from John McDonald all tonight on the Island Time Radio Show. Thank you to Cindy Muir for the interview.